Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be talking about another frequently asked question: can you dim the cockpit lights? Very interesting topic, so let's get started.
1383, runway 27, clear takeoff. United 1538, runway 27.
Now, during daytime hours, the cockpit is primarily lit by the sunlight entering through the cockpit windows. And ever so often, you try to block the sunlight with the cockpit sun visors to reduce the reflections on the monitors. This is one of the reasons why airplane cockpits' interiors are coated in gray or dark colors to reduce the sunlight reflection. And during that time, your LCD monitors and other indicating instruments and dials are at their brightest setting to ensure enough contrast from the surrounding daylight. This setting is great during transition from daytime and sunset, but as soon as it is pitch dark outside and you're preparing for approach and landing, you want to dim your cockpit lights for one primary reason only: eye adaptation. To give you an example, imagine you're sitting outside in your garden during a sunny day. Your eyes, or better, your iris, will be fairly small, blocking out the sunlight, otherwise you would be constantly squinting your eyes. Compare the iris to the diaphragm setting of your camera. Lots of light and the diaphragm will be very small. You then decide to get a cold drink from your garage fridge, and as soon as you walk into the dark garage, you will have difficulty even finding the light switch because your eyes have not yet adapted to the darkness, meaning your iris has to open up to let more light into your eyes so that you can see better in darkness. And this adaptation process can take up to 45 minutes. So imagine you're sitting in a well-lit cockpit during nighttime. Your iris will be relatively small to counteract the brightness of your monitors and the other instruments, so similar to what I've just mentioned with the sunny garden. And as soon as you look outside, which is comparable to our dark garage, your eyes will have trouble seeing airport lights and other important beacons helping you navigate to your destination. Therefore, all lights within the cockpit have to be dimmable to match the light sources coming from the outside, so your eyes can adapt to both light sources equally to reduce the effect of short-term night blindness. And you want to start dimming the cockpit lights at least 30 minutes prior to your landing in order to give your eyes enough time to adapt. Here you can see the reading floodlight being dimmed, the dome light turned off, the overhead panel integral light adjusted, the annunciator light set from bright to dim, the FCU backlight, the main pedestal floodlight and integral light, the navigation display and primary flight display, the upper and lower ECAM, and the MCDU. I also recommend dimming the EFB, the electronic flight bag, or iPad, as you'll be needing it throughout the approach phase and you don't want to get it blinded by the bright display as soon as you unlock it. And this is not just the case for airliners. Little Cessnas and Pipers have similar dimmer switches for their cockpit lights. And if you have the impression that the runway lights are too bright, you can request to dim the lights via tower frequency prior landing. But more about runway lighting system in a future video. By the way, the cockpit lights as required is one item in the preliminary cockpit preparation checklist shortly after setting electrical power to the aircraft and cockpit. So you can see the cockpit light setup is not just important for landing, but also for startup, taxi and takeoff. Another interesting fact, for the same reason, car manufacturers have installed dimmers so you can reduce the backlight of your speedometer and other gauges in case you are a night rider. I hope you enjoyed this short video about the cockpit instrument light settings. Make sure to perform a touch and go at my Instagram account. And if you're coming in at night, dim your lights. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button plus the notification bell so you won't miss out upcoming videos. Thank you very much for your time. All the best, your Captain Joe.